cuttlefish are not fish at all, and they're not particularly good at cuddling. Not that I've tried or anything, but these tentacled relatives of squid and octopus do have one amazing sneaky skill.
So I love cuttlefish because of their color changing abilities. You want to tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah, you know, it's the ability that cuttlefish and cephalopods can change their color is really, it's unmatched in the animal kingdom. It's no chameleon or fish or anything out there that can change color as instantaneously as these cephalopods. So how they do that is they have a whole bunch of little tiny cells in their skin called chromatophores. They're color changing cells.
Chromatophores are groups of pigment cells controlled by finely tuned muscles. When the muscles contract, the darker pigment is exposed and amazing patterns can emerge to give warnings or for camouflage, even to hypnotize their prey.
Joe, over in this tank here, we actually have several flamboyant cuttlefish. A lot of times when you see flamboyant cuttlefish resting, they're a little less flamboyant, meaning that they'll blend in with their surroundings, seagrass or a rock or something. But when I add some stimulus, like this little maintenance tool, they may flash to a very extremely bright color. It's thought that this bright coloration signifies that they're poisonous.
Whoa, that is awesome. I'm terrified of this thing, actually. I gotta be honest. I would not eat that.
That's the idea. It's one of the most advanced nervous systems and invertebrates that's on the planet.
Well, I've got a more advanced central nervous system than a cuttlefish. How hard can camouflage be?
How do you know a cuttlefish from a squid?
That's a really good question. Cuttlefish and squid look very similar. The main distinguishing feature is that cuttlefish possess a cuttle bone, which is a porous calcium carbonate shell inside of their body, and they'll use this cuttle bone to control their buoyancy. And so they can either fill this porous cuttle bone with water to sink in the water column or with air, and then they'll rise up in the water column. You may have also seen these cuttle bones at your local pet store, because parrots commonly eat cuttle bones as a source of calcium. So
my parents had parakeets and had one of those. I always wondered what it was.
Using their skirt and siphon, cuttlefish are incredibly maneuverable. They're able to move backwards and forwards, or tentacle words and head words.
So Bret, it's really nice that you've decided to clean up some litter from Monterey Bay here. What are we looking at with all these bottles?
So the female cuttlefish will lay her eggs on a shell or a rock, and then we can place them in these incubation chambers here, which, as you pointed out, are made from recycled soda bottles.
So we got a cephalopod recycled bottle nursery.
Yes.
Unlike squids and octopuses, cuttlefish have no immature developmental stage. They're born as miniature versions of their adult form, so they're able to disguise themselves even when they're tiny babies.
Here we have a tank full of small, stumpy cuttlefish hatchlings. At this size, they're very vulnerable to predation, so camouflage does play an important part of their surviving. Just to demonstrate the point of how good they are, I'm gonna move some of this rock work around so we can see how many there actually are in here.
Bret, thanks for showing me around this cuttlefish cephalopod exhibit. You have any final words of wisdom?
How many tickles does it take to make a cuttlefish laugh?
How many tickles does it take?
It takes 10 tickles. 10 tickles.
I think we're done here.
If you thought cuttlefish were awesome, check out the rest of our playlist from Monterey Bay. We've got a lot of otter great videos coming your way. Stay curious. Monterey, California, an idyllic seaside town. Tourists cram its busy streets, modern comforts at every turn. The Bay is an ocean sanctuary. It's home to hundreds of species from up and down the California coast. But as I walk around this tourist town, I got the feeling that it wasn't always like this. Long before people came to Monterey to watch fish, they came here to catch them, and they caught a lot of one fish in particular. And to get some more answers, I needed someone with historical knowledge and a sardine in his pocket.
So this is the Monterey sardine. This fish produces a lot of oil, and it's large, it creates a lot of fish meat.